25 years ago today, national scandal touched off by a Senate investigation. Disclosures by Senator Black's committee led to cancellation of all airmail contracts, the lifeblood of our fledgling airlines. Among those involved, manufacturers, airlines officials, many former government figures. The last civilian airmail flight was made in February, Eddie Rickenbacker piloting partway the first of the famed Douglas DC transports to enter service. Ultra-modern for its day, it arrived as the Army Air Corps was sworn in for the job of flying the mail. A job of staggering proportions. In one of the worst winters in years, they were to fly open cockpit planes by the seat of their pants without instruments in all weather over unfamiliar routes to bring the mail through. Many were superb airmen, destined to win fame in later years, but they flew planes that were pitifully obsolete. America's first-line warplanes were years behind even our own commercial craft. Slower, shorter-ranged, more cumbersome. It was a time of valor and heroism and of tragedy. For the nation, the bitter lesson that our Air Corps was too poorly equipped to do the job. For the service, a time of heavy loss and bitter frustration. The president ordered mail schedules sharply curtailed as the death toll mounted. Experts such as Charles Lindbergh conferred with Secretary of War Dern on needed improvements in training and equipment. The nation's pride in its fighting forces was rudely jolted. In May, new civilian contracts were let by the government, and the Air Corps relinquished its task to the airlines. Colonel Henry Hickam turned over the first load to airline pilot Jack Knight, and the episode passed into history, never to be forgotten by our airmen.